Appearing before the BBI Task Force Committee, the National Assembly Security and Administration Committee Chairperson Paul Koinange criticized the current census policy, whereby Kenyans are required to state their tribe, saying it was against the endeavor of building one nation.
That we completely do away with the institutionalized tribalism. Let us remove the tribal statistic from our future census. Let us behold enough and remove the home district from our national identity cards and all other official documents.
The Security Committee also wants national identity cards to only state the county of origin of the holder instead of district, division, and village.
Almost 6 years after independence, we still have our national ID cards bearing our home district. Census results bear statistics on the number of people belonging to each individual tribes.
Kenya National Union of Teachers also presented their memorandum that seeks to have Teachers Service Commission domiciled in the Ministry of Education. The Teachers Union argues the current policy whereby TSC handled teachers while the ministry handled other aspects of education was causing conflict in the sector.
The cases that we are witnessing now down at the field committee chair are pathetic. The county director education calls for a meeting. The county director TSC cancels the meeting and says, I was not informed.
The Association of Retired Police presented their memorandum calling for detachment of Directorate of Criminal Investigations from the National Police Service. Former Director DCI Francis Sang argued the directorate needed to be anchored in the Constitution and its mandates clearly spelled out.
We need actually to professionalize these officers so that if the DCI or the Director General of KBI will not be accountable, then you should actually be held responsible.
The Sabaot community, led by Endebess MP Robert Pukose, also engaged the task force, pushing for creation of Mount Elgon County. The Sabaot argue they have been marginalized by the Trans Nzoia and Bungoma counties where they reside. The Yusuf Hajj-led committee is expected to complete the validation process tomorrow before retreating to compile a report. Kevin Wachira, Channel One News.